The worst part was that I couldn't find anything to wear when I was looking for something. Make decluttering fun. Deal with unwanted stuff straight away, put it away, get rid of it, and then you're done. So decluttering feels like it is easy. You just throw away the stuff that you don't use and that's it, right? But for many of us, clutter-free home is sometimes really difficult because we don't have enough time, we are not motivated, we don't know what to do with the stuff. So if this sounds familiar to you, don't worry, you're not alone. But with a little bit of strategy and planning, decluttering, you can make easy for yourself. And how? I prepared 5+1 tip how to do it really effectively. So let's get straight to the video. Tip number one, start in an easy place. Choose a place that won't take a long time to declutter, isn't filled with a lot of stuff. For me, I think probably the easiest place or room to declutter was bathroom, because it's a small place, it's a small room, there are no sentimental items, I know what I use, I know what I don't use, and there's not a lot of stuff to slow you down or to lose the motivation. But please don't start decluttering in your garage or in your basement. Tip number two, start with an area that will make you feel good. To use my own experience, I started decluttering my wardrobe. I had a wardrobe of a lot of stuff, a lot of clothes, but I was not wearing maybe 60% of them. The worst part was that I couldn't find anything to wear when I was looking for something. So at the end, I end up reaching for black leggings or black jeans and with some blouse. But when I decluttered my wardrobe, I got rid of more than a half of my wardrobe. I donated it or I sell it. And I only kept clothes that I really wear, that I really like, that I feel comfortable in. And getting dressed in the morning is much more easier and a lot of quicker. Tip number three, make decluttering fun. I know, not all of us like to tidy up, but make fun of it. Choose a time when you are in a good mood, when you are motivated, play some music, sing along. After you are finished, reward yourself with some tea or some warm coffee, or with something sweet, treat yourself, go to the park. It will motivate you for your next decluttering. Tip number four, declutter little but often. You might find it easier and more convenient to declutter more often, rather than decluttering big blocks of time. For me, doing like 10 to 20 minutes constantly will get me more results than doing nothing for weeks and then spend the whole Saturday only decluttering. Tip number five, mark your decluttering on your calendar. Mark out the time when you want to declutter so you won't forget about it or put it off. It will also help you to make sure that you set aside a time for decluttering and you won't double book yourself for something else. The last but not least, deal with your stuff straight away. Don't be tempted to sit back and think that you are done until the rubbish is in the bin or donated or recycled. Otherwise, your friends or your family will find the garbage, pull out the items, and your work, your hard work was for nothing. So as I said, deal with unwanted stuff straight away, put it away, get rid of it, and then you're done. It's really easy to think that decluttering is time consuming or so hard to do, but it's only about getting a good strategy and some tactics to follow. Let me know if you have some other good tips and tricks how to make decluttering more easier, more fun, more effective. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, please subscribe to my channel if you like videos about minimalism, low-waste lifestyle, or veganism. If you would like to know more about me, then follow me on my social networks like Instagram or Facebook, or you can read my blog. Be good, be nice to yourself, be kind to the others, and I hope I will see you next Sunday in the next video. Bye!